completed this new academic year 2021-22. Loving God, our Creator, our companion, and our Supreme Power, bless this journey of a new academic year. Allow us to experience your presence in the many blessings you put before us. Open our eyes to new challenges and exciting opportunities. In this new year, open our hearts and our minds to new situations. Refresh our souls and renew our spirits.
Blessed are you, Creator, God of new beginnings. For you challenge us to constantly move beyond our past and call us into fresh possibilities for the future. Blessed are you, Lord of the impossible, for you never get discouraged and never cease to hope, believe and strive for a happy, for a happier, fairer world. Blessed are you, God of the covenant, for you make promises and never break them. For you trust us to do good and love us even when we fail, daily renewing our confidence and courage.
God of unconditional love, help us to believe in ourselves as you believe in us. Help us to see our potential as you see it. Constantly provide us with the new opportunities which your covenant promises, and inspire us with the dreams to follow new paths of potential, growth and goodness.
Before we begin this new academic year, let us take some time to consider how we each can strive for a happier and fairer world in and through our school communities. Let us take some time to think about how we are called to encourage and build up confidence in ourselves and in others. Let us become more aware of the opportunities all around us to be Christ-like to those we encounter.
And prosperity. It removes the darkness and brings positivity. Dispelling darkness makes way for the spirit of holiness. Today we ask God the Father to bless our students, open their minds to understand what is right and just. O Lord, let their mind radiate goodness like a lamp radiates to its light rays. Let your light guide all our students as they start their new classes and new learning days.
We can recall the words of Solomon, who said that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. We offer these books which symbolize our search for wisdom. O Lord, fill our hearts with a reverential fear and a holy love for you, so that we may approach all that we study with a sense of sanctity and make our daily studies a beautiful prayer to you. Born. O Lord, you have called us to enjoy our daily life with the freedom of a child. You invite us to rest from our hard labor and spend time enjoying our freedom of being your child. We offer you all our physical activities for strengthening and nourish our body when we enjoy your presence and your protection. May our leisure and play be a beautiful prayer before you.
Pen, pencil or eraser. O Lord, we offer you these writing materials which symbolize our reflections, which is the output of our understanding of the concepts that we have learnt. O Lord, we ask you to enlighten our minds and illumine it with your grace so that we might become people who reflect and ask genuine questions and thereby grow into wisdom and maturity. May our reflections and hard labor bring our understanding closer to eternal truth.
Scientific instruments. Light. O Lord, you have always inspired human hearts and minds to search for truth and wisdom. We cannot reach the truth without your aid. We offer these scientific instruments, which are the symbol of mind, which have been enlightened by your grace. O Lord, may our understanding be always inspired by your divine spirit and be always obedient to the inspirations of your spirit.
Computer. Lord, the source of knowledge, you have always come to the aid of people who are in need of you. You have always provided us with opportunities and helping aids to make our life simple and easy. Lord, We offer these parts of the computer, which is the symbol of your helping presence in our midst. This machine has influenced all over our lives and has made our living simple. Similarly, bless each one of us so that we make the life of others easy by extending our helping hands to others. We also ask you to give us the grace to make responsible use of gadgets that you have given us. Lord, make us responsible for ourselves and for our society.
Candle. Dear Lord, we are the salt and light of the earth. And if the salt loses its gloss, think how shall it be seasoned. Father, let this light symbolize the dispelling of darkness and in within the world, and that the light of Lord will shine like never before. Lord, let the light shine in the darkness, and we pray that the darkness will never overcome. Food.
God of all creation, all you have made is good, and your love endless forever. You bring forth bread from the earth and fruit from the vine. Nourish us with these gifts that we might be for the world signs of your gracious presence in the Lord our Father.
Flowers. Lord, as we offer these flowers, we offer all our desires and dreads, a symbol of what we are and what we want to become. Lord, help us to bloom where we are planted and spread the fragrance of your love and peace.
Art and craft. God, the Almighty, created the world, all its creatures, and saw that it was good. Art is not what you see, but what you make others see. Bless those tools of creativity, O God of creation, who help the creators to make the world a more joyful and beautiful realm. The arts give expression to the beauty of faith and proclaim the gospel message of grandeur of God's creation.
Deepa Ganatma Subhaya.
remind us who to pray for. The thumb is the closest fingers to you. So start praying for those who are closest to you. They are the persons easiest to remember. Think of all of those who are dear to you. This is often families and friends. Think of their special needs at this time and pray for them by name.
The next finger is the index finger. Pray for those who teach you, instruct you, and heal you. They need the support and wisdom to show direction to others. These could be parents, grandparents, teachers, priests, etc. Ask the Holy Spirit to strengthen them in their own lives and help them understand how to help you. Pray for them by name.
The following finger is the tallest. It reminds us of our leaders, the governors, and those who have authority. They need God's guidance. Pray that they might lead a country and society in a direction which brings us closer to God. Ask the Holy Spirit to inspire them to do what is right. Think of the issues in the news and pray that our leaders have the wisdom to make good decisions in these matters.
The fourth finger is the ring finger. It is the weakest finger. It should remind us to pray for the weakest, the sick, or those plagued by problems. They need our prayers. Pray for those in the margins, the poor, the sick, the young, the aged, the ignored, and the discarded. Ask for the strength and courage to serve others. And finally, we have our small finger, the smallest of all. Your finger should remind you to pray for yourself. Loving Father, be with us during the coming year. Keep us safe. Continue to guide us in your ways and show us how we can reflect your love to others as you would want us to do.
A reading from the Holy Bible. The Lord who created, He says, do not be afraid. I am with you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you pass through deep waters, I'll be with you. Your troubles will not overwhelm you. When you pass through fire, you will not be burned. The hard trials that come will not hurt you. For I am the Lord, your God, the Holy God of Israel, who saves you. I will give up all nations to save your life, because you are precious to me and because I love you and give you honor. Do not be afraid, I am with you. This is the word of the Lord.
God, you walk with us everywhere we go. May the strength of God sustain us. May the power of God preserve us. May the hands of God protect us. And the way of God direct us. May the matters discussed serve as a catalyst to move us forward and cause us to advance and see growth in all areas of our lives. Let us welcome this new academic session with new energies and hopes. Let us once again take this chance to begin afresh with new goals and new challenges. Thank you. school closures and significant shifts from normal routines. We all think tremendous thought as we traverse another year.